I recently had someone reach out to me on how to add a term of service banner in a Remix app that leverages cookies so that when you click accept and you refresh the page, it shouldn't show up. If the user has seen the term of services, they shouldn't see them again. They've already accepted them. However, this can change if the term of service date is later than the last time that they read the term of service, meaning that it updated. So if I save, this should update with a new term of service that says, as of July 23rd, we have new terms of services. So how do we accomplish this in Remix? Well, let's dive into some code. So the first thing that we're going to want to do is set up a cookie to derive whether or not this term of service banner should show up. Right now, we're just showing it all the time, which isn't very useful. We need that to be driven by the cookie itself. This is actually pretty easy to do. Let's create a separate file inside of app called cookie.server.ts. In here, we can import from Remix run, and we can use Node in this case, but you'll use Cloudflare or whatever adapter that you're using for your particular runtime. And here we can pull out create cookie. Underneath, we'll export const TOS banner cookie and then create the cookie and just give this a name, banner. And very simply, we're just going to give it a max age of 31536000. This is just 1 year. That's the max age that a cookie really can be. So no reason to put anything higher than that. Oh, this should be a six. Okay, so we'll go to root and we'll export a function called loader, which will take some args. Those will be loader args. And then it's going to return something. Well, first we need to get the cookie header. That's going to come off of the request, which we can get from the args. Dot headers. Dot get, and we're just going to get the cookie. And then we'll do const cookie equals await TOS banner cookie dot parse the cookie header. And that'll give us the actual cookie itself. This needs to be an async function if we're going to use await. Okay, so on the left-hand side, things blow up because we're not actually returning anything from the loader function. So we are going to return JSON, and that'll be something. We can just do something like show TOS banner and set it to true for now. So down below, we're going to say const equals use loader data. And in the generic of this, we can pass in the type of loader. And that'll let us know what we can actually pull out, show TOS banner. That's nice. And here we can say show TOS banner. Otherwise, that should be null. Okay, let's refresh the left-hand side. There we can see our TOS banner, but again, we need to actually leverage the cookie to tell us whether or not we should be showing the TOS banner. So first we want to say if the cookie even exists, we should return that JSON, and we can just return something like cookie.showTOSBanner. But otherwise, if the cookie doesn't exist, we want to create it. So we're going to return here a JSON, and we'll say the same thing, showTOSBanner. But this time it'll be false. And the next thing that we can add is we can add some headers. Oops, not head, headers. And here we're actually going to set cookie. This would be an await TOS banner cookie dot serialize. And we'll say show TOS banner to be false. Okay, here it looks like it's picking up on a cookie already set. So we can go ahead and clear the cookies that we have in the application, refresh. Okay, on the left-hand side, we don't actually see the term of service banner, and that's because I did this logic wrong. This should really be true. If the cookie has been set, we want to show the banner, not false. Cool, so now it's there, but if we click accept, it doesn't go away. So that's the next thing we need to add. I'm realizing I spelled this wrong. I did cookier. That's not what I want. I want cookie header. All right, so how to actually clear the cookie? Well, let's go to the term of service banner, and down below, we can see that we do have this button. Right now, I have an on-click handler, and it just says do something. Well, we don't really need to use an on-click handler. Remember, we're in Remix world and they like to do things the old way. So we're actually just going to use a form. And here we can use the form that comes from Remix run, but I actually am going to use something called use fetcher. So above I'll do fetcher equals use fetcher. And this is nice because this allows me to fetch, but not actually change the route. If I have a form, it's going to automatically change the route unless I override that. So this might be a little bit easier. Here we can do fetcher.form and we'll make sure that it gets wrapped correctly. This is going to be a method of post because we are posting that the cookie should update, should change, it should be set to false. And then the action can be to a specific URL that we want. This term of service banner is just a component, so we can't actually commit the action here. We need to go somewhere. So in this case, I'm going to go to a URL called hide TOS banner. And we'll go ahead and create this. So inside the routes, we can create a new file called hide tosbanner.tsx. And we need to export an async function called action. And we're going to want the action args to get all the right types and whatnot. Probably need the request here. And below, we can return JSON. We don't really need to return anything, actually. We do need to set these headers. And we'll set set cookie. And here again, we need to pull out the cookie itself. Wait, and then we'll get that TOS banner cookie. We're going to parse. And then what was it called before? What do we have? We had show TOS banner. So we want to use that again. And this time we're going to say false. And this isn't parse. This is actually serialize. I'm committing the cookie here. This is upset because it wants this to be typed. It's just ESLint stuff. We'll remove the JSON in this one, and then remove the action args in this one, and the type here, not comma. Okay, if I did everything right, this should hopefully work. We click accept, and there we go. TOS banner is gone. If I open up the console and I remove that cookie, refresh, we can see it's there again, which is super cool. That's what we want, right? There's a little bit more that we want to do here. First of all, if we disable JavaScript and we run this request, we're actually going to end up on this hide-tos-banner.tsx page, which isn't great. So if you go to hide TOS banner, you can see unexpected server error. So the first thing that it wants us to do is export async function loader. Here we'll return a JSON that just says not allowed with a status of 403, because that means not allowed. Should spell that right. If we refresh, we can see that it says not allowed. So if somehow someone does get on this page, it'll just tell them, hey, you shouldn't be here. In this action, we could also take this a step further. We could redirect from this action directly, which would be really nice. Instead of returning JSON, we can just redirect. And instead of this empty thing, we need to redirect to a place. So I could just redirect to the root, which might be fine. But ideally, I would go back to the page that this came from. First, let's move this down here because we don't need that right there. And again, add this type. And so let's go back to the TOS banner. So here we could add an input of type equals hidden. Actually, it doesn't need to be a type. It can just be hidden. And then name will say redirect URL. And then the value equals, well, basically where we're at. And to get that, we can go up here and say const. We'll use location, which comes from remix run React. We need to call it, of course, because it's a hook. And then we'll get the path name. And then we'll get the, let's see, is there anything else we want? Yes, we want the search, which is like the URL param. So if you had like question mark q equals something, all that stuff, we want to preserve that. We just want to go back to the exact same spot. So we'll say path name plus the search. That should be good. And of course, we need to self-close this. And we can say read only, just so that we know this is read only. It shouldn't change. Cool. Now in hide TOS banner, we want to say request.formData. And then we actually called get after that. Oh, of course, this isn't a wait because form data is asynchronous, I guess. And we can pull off that redirect URL because that's what we called it. So that'll take redirect URL, and then we can call this redirect URL. Here we'll pass in redirect URL, and we'll fall back to the root in case for some reason this redirect URL did not work. Of course, this wants us to know if this is a string or not. Just TypeScript is trying to be super safe. So we'll say type of that. That equals a string, then we'll use redirect URL. Otherwise, we'll default to the root. Okay, to make sure this works, let's just add a like test.tsx route export default function. We'll return h1. Hi. Yeah, that should be enough for us to get going. So here we'll go to test. Okay, yeah, it says hi. That's good. So if I click accept, oh, it does go to hi, but that's because we have JavaScript enabled. So by default, we have a good experience. But what I wanted to see is if I remove this and then I disable JavaScript, give this a refresh. If I click accept, it will go back to test, which is exactly what we wanted because we set that up correctly to use that redirect URL, which comes from TOS banner, which is the path name plus the search. So this is working exactly how we want. Just to make sure this is working, I can comment this out and then I'll delete the cookie, refresh, I'll click accept, and there you go, it goes back to root. So that's how we know that is working correctly. All right, let me enable JavaScript again. I think we're done with that. And I'll clear this cookie just to make sure everything's working. Cool. So the last thing we want to do is we actually want to use the date. Right now we have July 11th, but we want to just use any arbitrary date basically to determine whether or not this should be set. And we have that up here, 7/11/2022. But if this was updated to a date later than when we actually read the terms of service, then this terms of service should show up again. So instead of using show TOS banner, I want to use something that tells us when the cookie was actually read. So here, when we're setting it, we're just going to call this date terms of service read. And by default, we'll set that to 0. We'll just pretend that they read it at the beginning of the dawn of time, I guess, or 1970, whatever. And this we can keep as show TOS banner because that is actually what's used inside an app, which is what determines the TOS banner. So this is really just about the cookie, and this is about what we actually want to send to our component. But instead of saying cookie.show TOS banner, we're going to be using date.TOS read, right? And here we just want to say, is this less than the last updated date? Because if it's less than that last updated date, that means it's out of date. We should, in fact, show it. But if it's greater than that last updated date, then it's false. We don't need to show it. They're good. They've read the terms, or at least they pretended that they read them. They accepted them at the very least. So let's save that. And the banner went away, so that's cool. But let's update this really fast and see what happens. Okay, nothing changed. And I think that's because the TOS banner has not been updated in the action. So let me just delete this really fast. And we'll refresh. Everything shows up. We'll change this back to 11. Oop, 11. Refresh this. And inside of our action, we need to change this from show TOS banner to date TOS read. And here we're going to say new date dot value of to get an actual number. Cool, let's try that. So we're going to accept. It goes away. And TOS banner, let's change this to like the 23rd, which is tomorrow. And it shows up. Perfect. And it says as of July 23rd, 2022, we've updated our terms. So I can accept that. And actually, it's never going to go away because it is using the current day. So since this is in the future, that doesn't really work. Need to account for that, of course, with your real users. Biggest way to account for it is don't update the date to a future date because that doesn't even make any sense. What does that mean that you updated your terms of service tomorrow? So really, that's just a human error thing. But again, if we go back to any previous date, this will be gone, which is super cool. And that's exactly what we want. So yeah, this is a really simple way to add a terms of service banner using a cookie. I hope you learned something. I hope you learned a little bit about using cookies and Remix. There's obviously a lot more that we could do here. We can make this a little bit more sophisticated if we want. We should probably add some content to our application. But this is a nice way just to get started with cookies and terms of service banners.